Hello, my name is Nathan Schultz. I'm the Assistive Technology Specialist at the Student Access Services in the LRC, and today I'm going to be showing you how to use Glean, the note-taking app that will allow you to take multimedia notes from any device from your browser. So let's get started. After we invite you to use Glean, you'll receive an email just like this one. Go ahead and click the email, and then click Accept Invite. It'll take you to a page asking you to confirm your email and name. Make sure you confirm that your name is correct. Click Continue, and then you'll enter a password that you want to use for your Glean account. I'll enter one now. And then just click You have read and agreed to the service agreement and privacy policy. And then click Create Account. If you want, you can watch the short introduction video, or you can continue watching and this video will provide a very comprehensive review of the Glean app, and then just click Continue. To log back into your Glean account, go to your Google search bar, type app.glean.co, press Enter. That will take you to the login page. Enter your email address and your password. Click Login, and you have successfully logged into Glean. To create your first Glean event, click on the center button that says New Event, and that will take you to the Glean event screen. If you've already created an event, just click on the New Event button in the top left corner, and it will take you to the same New Event page. This is the screen that you'll see anytime you create a new event in Glean. On the right side of the screen, you can see any audio that you recorded during the lecture. On the left side of the screen, you can see your slides and notes when you type them out. On the bottom part of the screen, you can see the note box, which will allow you to type notes, create headings, and add labels. On the top bar, you can see the record, play, playback speed, event name, and other options. And you can also return to events on your home screen. Let's go ahead and add a title to our event. It's recommended that you use a title that relates to your lecture. So for this one, I'm going to use Index of Coincidence. And now let's add some slides. To add slides, click on this Import Slides button in the center on the left side. And that will open up a file selection menu. And then you'll want to select the slides that you want to add. At this moment, Glean only supports PowerPoints in the form of PDF, but if you only have PowerPoints in the form of PowerPoint documents, that's all right. I'll show you how to convert those to PDFs at the end of this video. Then click Open. That will open up the slides in Glean. You can navigate through the slides by clicking the arrows at the bottom. And you can return to the slide that you're currently on in Glean by clicking this blue arrow, show slide one. The main feature of Glean is being able to record audio that gets added to your notes. So let's go ahead and do that. When you click on the record button, you'll see three options. The first one is for microphone. This is for if you're in an in-person lecture and you have a microphone that you can use to record the lecture. In order to do that, you'll click microphone. And when Chrome prompts you to use your microphone, you'll click allow. And it'll start recording on the right-hand side. As you can see, it's recording my voice right now. If I stop speaking, then it adds a gap to the recording. These gaps allow you to section your notes off and be able to find key points in your lecture easily. Let's say you're in a virtual meeting and you want to record the audio from a Zoom meeting or a YouTube video. That's all right, you can do that too. If you click on the record button, these bottom two options will allow you to capture screen audio. The first option will capture screen audio without capturing your mic, and the second option will capture your screen audio and capture your mic, so that way if you ask the professors any questions, you can record that for later. For now, I'm just going to go ahead and click the screen audio selection. After you select that, Chrome will prompt you three options. It'll ask you if you want to share your entire screen, it'll ask you if you want to share your window, or if you want to share your Chrome tab. In this case, I'm going to elect to share a Chrome tab, and I will want to make sure that for either option, the Share Audio tab is selected. I'll click on the tab that I want to share and click Share. Chrome will now tell you that the tab is being shared, so go ahead and return to the Glean tab. And now you can see that the audio is recording, so if I click play on the video, audio will start showing up. Okay, I switched my views here so you can see both the lecture and Glean. When the professor posts the first slide, you can go and click this button down here that says post slide. What that will do is it will put a note in your audio saying that this is where slide one started. And now I can start taking notes. Let's say I wanted to take a note that said index of coincidence is important for later, just for example. Now I can press enter, it will show the note in the note tab and automatically show the note where I placed it on the slide, this little gray dot right here. When the professor moves over to the next slide, I can navigate to the next slide and click post slide, and that will start by saying that slide two is now being recorded. You can also create labels and headings that can help you organize your text notes in Glean. For example, if I wanted to create a heading that told me to review a task right here, I would click the audio, I would click review, and then I would type whatever is relevant to the review. So I'll type, let's just say review in this case. Now, if I come up to the new review label that has been created, I can press play, and that will play back the audio from where the review, from the first audio blurb of the review. If I click the next arrow, it'll jump to the next audio blurb. And if I press the back arrow, it'll jump to the previous audio blurb. If I click on the time of the label and I use the just start or just end arrows, I can adjust where the review note ends, and I can adjust where it starts. So if I click the right arrow, it'll move it one audio blurb to the right. And if I click the left arrow, it'll move it to the left. Same thing with the end. If I click the right, it'll move the end by another blurb. And if I click the left, it'll reduce it by a blurb. There are three types of labels you can use in Glean: the important label, review label, and task label. And each one can be accessed by clicking on either one. You can also create headings, which allows you to section your audio into named sections. For example, here at slide two, if I wanted to add a heading that said formula, I could click on the heading button, type formula, and press enter. And that adds a section called formula above slide two. You can also add images to your audio notes. If I want to add a chart to slide two, I could click on the image button above the text box, select the image that I want to insert, click open, and that will insert an image note in slide two. If you were in the middle of a lecture and the lecture is moving really fast and you don't have time to stop and take notes, that's all right, because you can come back and add text notes later. And one tool that you can use for this is called lightning mode. Let's start playing this audio. If I come down to the bottom right and click the lightning button, that will open up lightning mode, which allows me to use the number shortcuts to enter headings and labels wherever I want. So if I press 2, it'll enter an important label. If I press 3, it'll enter a review label. If I press 4, it'll insert a task label. And if I press 1, it'll insert a heading at the cursor location. I can click on the lightning mode logo to go back to regular text box mode. And I can come back later and add notes to my labels. You can also create different collections that allows you to add all of your class notes from one class into one place. If I come to the Glean homepage and click on collections in the left bar, and then I click new collection, it'll come up with this page. I can add my collection name at the top bar, let's say cryptography in this case. Then if I come back to my left bar and click home, I can hover over where it says collection on the event that I want to move, click move event, and click the collection that I want to move it to, in this case, cryptography. It has now moved the event to cryptography, and if I go back to that collection, I can access any of the events that I've made for that class. Just as a quick side note, I'd like to show you how to convert any PowerPoint to a PDF. If I click on file in the top left, click export in the left bar, and then click create PDF / XPS document, I can click this button, which will take me to a menu to name the PDF. I'm just going to keep the same name, and then you'll click publish. Then it'll pull up the PDF and you'll know it worked, and it'll save wherever you asked it to be saved. So in this case, it's saved in my downloads folder. All right, that's all I have to show you. If you have any questions, you can come to our office in the LRC at room 106, or you can email our office at studentaccessservices@rose.edu.